Hi friends, in this video we are going to learn how to use and configure the visitor management system. So first we are going to install the visitor management system. Double click and open the software. Put the admin password, admin and admin for default password. Then hit the login button. As your software is open, so you can do in this software to normally check in, check out for the visitor, if any delivery, courier, report, setting, database, and log out for the session. You can see real time visitor, contractor, and staff how many in. So once we go in the setting first time, so we have to update the company profile. Click the company, company detail, put your company name, apartment name, address, and the contact person name, number. So that after that, upload the logo or any image for your company. After upload the image, hit the update button and OK. Then this session is done. So you can adjust the width and the height for the your header. So here you can add user and admin. If you have the single license, then you can add only maximum one user and one admin. If you have the multiple license, you can add the more user and more admin in your software. So after this done, we close this thing and we go to check-in, visitor or contractor, anyone. You can see their default one and default two and default three. This heading we can change to our according to our apartment, our company, and purpose of visit, how many we have, we can put inside the form. This all thing is customizable. So we hit the setting button, go destination field, default one. Like if you are in apartment, you can put a block, how many block have you in apartment. I just put the block number or block. After block is which level, which floor. So I just hit the floor here, and the house number or unit number, up to you how you are convenient, you can update this heading. I'm just going to write the unit number and hit the update button. After done update, we go and check in our form. It's already updated. You can see there the heading is already updated. The floor, visitor, and this. Now we can customize the drop down. So for the drop down customize, we go to the setting, we go to destination field. After destination field, we have right here block, like how many block you have, block A, block B, block C, how you are convenient to according to your company, your apartment, you can write here. Like if you have the department, you can write department, or if you have the area, you can write at area. If you have the road, you can write at road. Anything up to you, how you are convenient, you can write to be here. So under the block A, what you have, first floor, second floor, third floor, how many floor you have, all you are one by one going to add here. Once you have add all the floor here in the block A, you can configure your second block, like the block B and block C. Up to you is how many you have, all you can write down there. Then you have to put all the data for the block B and block C and block A, everything. So slowly we put all the data, everything. Just keep patience, write all the data according to your apartment, your company, write one by one all the block, everything. Then you can write the unit number, like they, if you have a company, you can select the department, write the employee names there, everything. If you have the block, you can write the unit number, house number, or office number. That all is pre-inserted here. So when your visitor comes, so guard just and drop and drag and select the things. After complete the entering data, then we can enter the, we can check in, sorry, in the visitor form. We have appear all the block A, block C, and under the blocks we have appear the floor, how many floor the block, and unit number, everything. So almost we are done. You can select anything from the, when your guard is performing the check-in, so they can select easily everything. So now we are going to enter purpose of the visit. So we go here, purpose of visit. The demo one always delete. After deleting this all the demo purpose, we can add like the meeting, courier delivery, anything according to your company or apartment, which is visitor is coming, sometime the service, some of the repairing parts or something, anything up to you. Or you can convenient, you can write down your purpose of visit list. All is updated in the software. It's make your guard to easy to use, and they can just drop down, select that visitor come for which purpose, they are coming for meeting, demo or anything, product demo, something. After getting this done, we just update all the setting, everything. All of up is done, then we go check in our form is appear. We go to the purpose of visit, you can see here all appear. Just now we enter. So after this, when any of the visitor is coming, your guard just click the check-in button. If the visitor is visitor, contractor is contractor. So you will write down the IC number, passport number or license number, anything. If you have the MyKad, just plug in the MyKad, hit the MyKad button. It will automatically read all the data. So after reading the data, you fill the form, everything, and select, and contact number is must be, and where the destination the person is going there, and you think the form all rest the guard can fill. So when he presses the check-in button, hit the check-in button, so system will ask him issue the card, visitor badge number, the card. So selecting everything, then hit the check-in button, then system will asking the card number, then it can print the visitor pass for the people. But after printing the pass, we just done everything. So when your visitor everything done, want to check out, hit the checkout button. Guard will scan the pass number, so it will automatically perform the checkout. So you can see here, first checkout and first check-in, second checkout. So like this, your guard very easily can sign in visitor and sign out the visitor. On the live, you can see on top how many visitor you have. In the report, you can see a registration report, how many visitor are registered in your system. You can blacklist the visitor. If something wrong with the visitor, you can blacklist them. So second time when they are try to check in through your guard process, system will not allow them to check in your building, your company or apartment, anything. So you can see there is showing the blacklist. So when your guard is trying to perform, it will show you the visitor is already blacklisted. So that mean admin can we do the whitelist again. If something wrong or something, everything okay with the visitor, so it can go again. The main admin, who is the admin in the software, it can make it whitelist. It can print the record for the visitor and put on the guardhouse or put on anywhere. So after that, we can see check-in visitor. Any of the visitor is showing you normal. So visitor can proceed for the check-in after you whitelist the visitor. See, is check-in. So when you want to check out, just click the checkout button and scan the pass. After scanning the pass, visitor will proceed to checkout successfully. So this all the data you can track in the report. check-in report, how many times the visitor is check-in, check-out, everything, where he go, everything, all the thing. And this report you can track by IC number, badge number, name or company detail, anything, which date to which date, search. Then you can export to Excel all the record for your reference. Once you hit the export button, wait for a while, it will perform the task where you want to save. After put the name, everything, then you can save the data in Excel. We can see in the Excel we have the data on our desktop. All the data we have in the desktop, that you easily you can print all the data or whatever you want to do with the data. Some of the lists you want to keep in your remotely, want to send the report, everything with the email, all can send through email. In case of emergency, you can hit the evacuate button and generate the list for the people who is inside your building, inside your company, everything, with the contact number. Then you can call them and evacuate from your building safely. Hope you understand how to use the software. Then after done everything, hit the logout button.